everyone, and welcome to this memorial service where tonight we take time to remember those who we love so much and yet still no longer. And so we remember right at the beginning of this service that the Lord Jesus said, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." So this evening will be a chance in our service to light a candle in the memory of those who come to remember tonight, and we'll have the names read out to those who come to remember, to just say before the Lord that we know that he sees each of your grief and he wants to meet you right there in any brokenness of heart that you still feel at this time. So we start off with praying together. Gracious God, Creator of love, we thank you now for each of our family members and friends who have now died. We thank you for all that each of them has meant to us, and as we honour their memories, make us more aware that you are the one from whom comes every perfect gift, including that gift of eternal life through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If you're comfortably able, let's stand together as we sing our first hymn.
Amen.
tonight. Amen.
Amen.
If you'd like to take a seat, we've got our first Bible reading there that Andrew is going to share with us.
Evening, everyone.
Evening.
The emergency tonight is Psalm 28. It's on page 557 of your church Bibles, if you'd like to follow. To you, Lord, I call. You are my rock. Do not turn a deaf ear to me. For if you remain silent, I shall be like those who go down to the pit. Hear my cry for mercy, as I call for you to help, as I lift up my hands towards your most holy place. Do not drag me away with the wicked, with those who do evil, who speak cordially with their neighbours, with harbour malice in their hearts. Repay them for their deeds and for their evil work. Repay them for what their hands have done, and bring back on them what they have deserved, because they have no regard for the deeds of the Lord and what his hands have done. He will tear them down and never build them up again. Praise be to the Lord, for he has heard my cry for mercy. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts him and he helps me. My heart leaps for joy, and with my song I praise him. The Lord is the strength of his people, a fortress of salvation for his anointed one. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Be their shepherd and carry them forever. And speak to God.
Thanks, Andrew. We have another reading as well this evening that Anne's going to share with us. The second reading is taken from 2 Corinthians 1, verses 1 to 11. It can be found on page 1159. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, to the Church of God in Corinth, together with all his holy people throughout Acacia. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us all in our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God. For just as we share abundantly in the sufferings of Christ, so also our comfort abounds through Christ. If we are distressed, it is for your comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is for your comfort, which produces in you patient endurance of the same sufferings we suffer. And our hope for you is firm, because we know that just as you share in our sufferings, so also you share in our comfort. We do not want you to be uniformed, brothers and sisters, about the troubles we experienced in the province of Asia. We were under great pressure, far beyond our ability to endure, so that we despaired of life itself. Indeed, we felt we had received the sentence of death. But this happened that we might not rely on ourselves, but on God, who raises the dead. He has delivered us from such a deadly peril, and he will deliver us again. On him we have set our hope, that he will continue to deliver us, as you help us by your prayers. Then many will give thanks on our behalf, for the gracious favour granted us, in answer to the prayers of many. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sam is going to share some words of comfort with us as we come to reflect on these Bible readings tonight. And I'll just pray for us before I share those words. So Lord, you know we come tonight with all sorts of emotions, mixed emotions, Lord, and yet we're here to remember and to honour those we've loved but see no longer. So we pray, Lord, that our hearts will be truly open to you in these moments. Thank you, God. Amen.
Amen.
So So I saw reading again, I had some wonderful words, and it says, the Lord is the strength of his people, a fortress of salvation for his anointed one. The Lord is my strength and my shield, my heart trusts in him, and he helps me. And the Christian claim is that in Jesus we can have comfort that we can find absolutely nowhere else. That in the Lord Jesus we can find comfort that is the sort of comfort that we might search otherwise in all kinds of places for such a long time and never be able to receive. And the Bible uses the word comfort in 31 places, and more than half appear in the second letter of Paul to the Corinthian Christians here in the New Testament. And in this passage alone, we see that word comfort mentioned 10 times. So Paul is sharing with the church in Corinth about the true comfort that he himself experienced amidst suffering. The passage is very practical because we, or our friends, need comfort. Often we struggle to find where we can get that comfort from, as I've just alluded to. And God has made us this promise. We believe that the Christian hope is that yes and amen find their true fulfilment in the person of Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us on that cross. So if we're looking for comfort tonight, then we can know that we can truly have it in the person of Jesus. What the church leader Paul would say to us tonight is that we don't need to sort of think, oh well, you know, this will do, this sort of comfort I might get from things like looking at photographs of loved ones, as much as that can bring us huge comfort. In Jesus, we believe we can have greater comfort even than that. And the second letter to the Corinthians, it is a letter that is different in its opening. We notice that it's very different to the other letters of Paul, because Paul usually gives thanks for God's gospel in the work of the churches. I thank my God for all of you, he says at the start of Romans. At the start of 1 Corinthians, he says, I give thanks to my God always for you. In Philippians, he says, I thank my God in my remembrance of you. But he omits that completely in the second letter to the Corinthians. He carries straight on from praising God into what he's saying. And the importance of that is the fact that Paul was acknowledging the suffering that they were going through. So he wanted to convey more than anything that the comfort and the reassurance they needed was founded in God alone, as important and special as it can be to receive from fellow human beings. And what Paul wanted to do on this occasion is point beyond that towards the God of all comfort. So you see, when our hearts feel full of grief and we don't know what to do, we need something that will truly go deep and really deep into our very beings. And what Paul is saying is that he understands that we need the God who truly sees, the God who sees every single thing that's going on inside us when we suffer, and bereavement, when we suffer through any kind of hardship in our lives. Jesus, you see, he experienced such humiliation on the cross, and more than that, as he walked on this earth, he experienced every loss that we could go through as human beings. He's been there for us, so that we can look to him and realise that he understands. Because many people say that, don't they? Sometimes very much meaning well, oh, I know what you're going through. But we know that they don't, because they haven't suffered that specific and unique loss of that person in their life. So it is a unique response that we need when we grieve. We need a response from the Saviour who truly sees us inside and out. So as we come to church tonight, we have heavy hearts because we're grieving. There are so many emotions that we want to acknowledge here in this place tonight. And what I'd invite us all to remember above all else is that God has made an offer to each and every one of us in Jesus, that he will always be with us by the person of the Holy Spirit. We may not see Jesus with our eyes, but as we're open to God, we can know the Holy Spirit meeting us. We just need to say, Lord, I want to meet you. I want you to give me this comfort that you were talking about. And members of St. James is here tonight, and we can all reassure you that this is not a special gift that's just for the few. This is a gift that God longs to bestow on every person who will just be open and just say, okay, Lord, I am going to trust you. I won't hold back. I'll take that step of trusting you, and I'll see what's going to happen as a result. Over the 6.5 years now that I've been serving in ordained ministry, and before that as well, I've known some really vibrant Christians who've come to know the Lord as a direct result of losing someone very, very close to them. And it's as though suffering and comfort, they draw us into a real situation where we're kind of at a turning point. It can drive us away from God, very much so, or it can drive us into the arms of the Lord to experience that life and know that it can be true for us. It's as though suffering and salvation are kind of intertwined in many cases. And when we see friends in pain, we can confidently draw near to them. And when we've received that presence of God, the Holy Spirit, we can draw near to them and say, this is the good news. We've had the bad news about sin and death and all of the negative stuff, but the good news is we can have comfort and we can have power from God to not just see us through our days, but to give us a life that we maybe didn't even conceive of before. So our hope in Jesus, it's not just for now, it's a future hope. And deliverance isn't just immediate, it's something that can be dependent on God's timeline. We don't know when our breathing process will be fully complete. Something else I will say is that when we finish breathing, it's not like we've left behind our loved ones. We don't need to feel guilty. They'll always be a part of our lives. We take the memory of them with us wherever we go. And yet what God does when he gives us his comfort is he enables us to go forward in his strength, to take those memories forward and to enter into a whole new phase of life with him. The truth is that sickness and adversity can really cause us to rely on God. Because prosperity and health, when we're well and strong, they're great mercies, and we're so thankful when we have those things. And yet Jesus, I will put to you, is better than both of those things. And so as I draw these words to a close for us this evening, I'll just invite us all to take very seriously the difference that it could make for all of us, to place our trust more so in Jesus, to come to understand within ourselves that this God of all comfort, he's not speaking to us far off in the universe. He's not saying, okay, here you go, you've got a Bible, read that and you'll be okay. He's not saying that. He's saying, I can be your true saviour, your supreme friend. I can walk with you every day. I can minister to you very powerfully. Comfort that is just so, so deep and rich, and that just can enfold us completely. So how might it be for us if we were just to be open to this, to shift our focus from placing our hope and our trust in things that we could see with our eyes towards focusing on Jesus and placing our trust in him to see that he can really comfort us and he can give us more than we could ever, ever need. And then Paul, that early church leader, like Myself and many of us here at St James, we would just say to you that this is glorious hope and this is a glorious life that we can have as we're open to that comfort. And tonight, if you feel like questions are raised, then please also know that our lives are happening now. We don't need to leave our conversations that are important to next year or 5 or 10 years' time. We can tonight say to anyone here at St James, I want to ask about this real God. You know, I've not heard it said before so much that he's the God of comfort who can meet me, just personally. That is just something amazing. Let's realise tonight that this message is true because of who he is, and all glory can be to his name. Let's surrender our sorrows to Jesus and find out too that he is the restorer of our souls. Amen.
Amen.
So we have some songs now to help us to continue to reflect on what I've said and to remember that the Lord is listening to us about our loved ones here in this place tonight.
Oh,
A saving we meet in the name of Jesus Christ to remember those who have died, to remember them with love and thanksgiving, and to commend them afresh in our hearts and minds to God's steadfast love and care, believing that he who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father leads the way home to all who believe and trust in Christ. You, Christ, are the King of glory. You overcame the sting of death. You are seated at God's right hand in glory. Pete's going to pray for us and have a chance to come forward in our own time and to light a candle if that's something that we would like to do. So we remember with love in our hearts before the true and living God, baby Abel James Caddis. Douglas Oliver Birch. Dennis Sheldon. Sandra Hinton. Mitchell Percy Thacker. Maurice Stuart Wixon. Derek Brian Hooper. Patricia Marion Ward. Pete Nichols. Brian Vardy. Paul Murray. Bill Owen. Bell Pinches. And Darren Bennett. Thank you. Almighty Heavenly Father, remember as we look at the large candle that Jesus is the light of the world, who meets us in our mourning, in our pain, in our remembering. We thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let's join with the responses on the screen once again in one time. My remembering has made me cry. My remembering has made me laugh. My memories remind me of the guilty times. My memories remind me of the words you spoke. My remembering has given me new strength. My remembering has brought me healing. Father in heaven, we give you thanks for your servants. We praise you as we recollect their lives and cherish their memory. We bless you that in bearing your image they brought light into our lives. For we have seen in their friendship reflections of your compassion, in their integrity demonstrations of your goodness, in their faithfulness glimpses of your eternal love. We praise you for all you accomplished in them and through them. We thank you for your grace and mercy revealed to each of us in and through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To sing again, if you comfortably able, let us stand together.
Thank you.
There is a response after each section of prayer. If I say, Lord, in your love, could you respond, hear our prayer? So let us pray firstly for our loved ones. We remember with thanksgiving all we have named today. Thank you for everything we remember and treasure about them, for all that they mean to us. Take care of them, Lord, until we all reach that time and place where every tear is dry, every question answered, and all things are made new. Lord, in your love,
hear our prayer.
And a prayer for each of you. Father of all mercy, and giver of all comfort, give hope to those who are sad. Console those who still miss someone special. Grant peace to those who are angry. Help us to cast every care unto you, and guide us gently by your Holy Spirit through the challenges and opportunities of tomorrow. In thankfulness for the past, help us to live our lives to the full, in love and joy and peace. Lord, in your love.
Hear our prayer.
A prayer for all parents. Heavenly Father, we rejoice with thanks for all those who've guided and nurtured us in our lives. In a world that is broken and in need of your nurturing love, please use us to aid others as you do us, in providing comfort, nurture, protection, and support. We ask that you grow us as nurturers to those who lead us, so that we might celebrate your goodness together, even through our own brokenness. Lord, in your love.
Hear our prayer.
And a prayer for all carers. Loving God, we thank you for making us in your likeness with a spirit of concern and love. Thank you for giving us one another to care for, child, parent, spouse, friend or neighbour. Bless all who work in the medical and social professions, in surgeries, hospitals, the hospice and in the community. Keep us sensitive to the needs of others, and give us the grace to respond with patience and generosity. Lord, in your love.
Hear our prayer.
And a prayer of confession and forgiveness. Lord God, I'm troubled at times about mistakes made, opportunities missed, words that hurt. I'm truly sorry. Forgive me. Heal my regrets. And help me to forgive any wrongs done to me, so that I may find peace of mind and rediscover a life of joy and freedom. Amen.
Amen.
God knows our deepest longings. To all who are truly sorry, I assure you that nothing in the past, the present, or the future, nothing in life or even in death, can separate us from the love of God. We are forgiven. We are free and at peace. Amen.
Amen.
And we're going to have a period of silence now to allow you in the quiet to offer to God prayer for the things on your heart. And after a while, Gail will continue the service.
Thank you.
you, Lord, for that opportunity to start pouring out our hearts to you through our thoughts, our prayers today. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for the many memories that we have, and we pray, Lord, that we will find courage from knowing that through reflecting on those memories, our loved ones can carry on being a part of our lives. And may we also be guided by you to make the most of the time we have left here on this earth and find meaning for our lives by following you, placing our trust in you. Give us the courage, Lord, to do that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And we pray now the prayer that our Saviour Jesus has given to us. Our Father
in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins. We forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Have our closing hymn now, Love the Divine, or Love Sick Selling. Wonderful traditional hymn. If you come together, let's stand together.
Yes.
yet let's remember as we leave church tonight that Jesus is offer for us to experience a God who is the God of all comfort, is here right now in these days before we get to that point. Let's pray together this final prayer. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
May the Lord give to us all a quiet night and a perfect end.
Amen.